Hey, what's up? John Sonmez here from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I want to do a video today talking about compartmentalizing your life and why it's toxic. I am writing a book, or I've written a book, I'm editing the book. It's called The Complete Software Developer's Career Guide. You could, of course, check it out here. You could buy it, or you know, depending on, or you can sign up and get some of the chapters free. But either way, go to the link here, and depending on where you are in the timeline of the world, the appropriate thing will happen for you. In that book, I have a chapter on life-work balance, or work-life balance, and I talk about why I disagree with the idea, the concept in general. And I think I've done a few videos on this, but I want to hit home a really important point, because as I was going through and re-editing this book, it's just something that really just struck me, that dawned on me, that I think is really worth reiterating, because a lot of people don't think about this, and which is, like I said, this idea that compartmentalizing your life is toxic. And what I mean by that is that when you think about it, okay, I want to really hit home, like I said, on this one concept, which is just one idea I want you to really, really think about here, is just that this idea that if you compartmentalize your life and you make work work and you make life life and you don't like work, but you do like life, what's going to happen to you, right? It doesn't matter if you're employed, it doesn't matter if you're self-employed, it doesn't matter if you're an entrepreneur. Whatever your vocation is or how you're living your life, okay? If you do that, what's going to happen is that you are going to be spending a majority of your life sleeping and working and not living your life, right? So if you compartmentalize your life and you think about work as a separate thing and it's a bad thing, then how many hours are you gonna have in the day, right? So if we just think about this, right? If we just go over this, right? You've got 24 hours, I've got 24 hours, okay? We all have the same amount of time in a day. You take out about 8 hours to sleep, which you need to sleep about 8 hours, most people. I mean, some people can get away with less, but in general, okay? So that's gonna put us at 16 hours, okay? You're impressed by my very quick math skills, adding simple or subtracting simple digits. I know this, but I'm just gonna play it off like it's really smooth, okay? Now, so we got 16 hours, okay? Out of the 16 hours, how many hours do you work, right? So if we said, well, let's say 8, okay, then that would put us at, watch this again, 8. 16 minus 8 is 8. I know this is impressive to some of you. Okay, but you don't, right? Because you commute, you have a lot of other things that, you know, your work time is probably actually going to be about 10 hours, because there's a little bit of overhead, maybe 9, but let's say that 10, so that leaves you with 6 hours, okay? So 6 hours of your day, you get to live your life. Now, in that 6 hours, you gotta eat, okay? You gotta, like, you know, check your email. There's probably a bunch of things that you gotta do. You know, hang out with your kids, maybe do some laundry, some chores, some stuff you don't like, right? So maybe that's gonna eat up like an hour or two of your time. So maybe you have like 4 hours a day of living your life, of enjoying your life. To me, that is shit, okay? And if you think about it, the weekends, right, you've got, you work most of the week, you work 5 days out of the week, most of us, right? So you're spending 4 to 6 hours a day living your life during the weekdays, and then the weekends, you get to spend a little bit more time living your life. That's a shitty way to live, right? Are you gonna do that for 40 years? You're gonna do that for 50 years? And some people even, they won't even have fun at all during that time, right, during their 6 hours, because they're gonna wait until they retire, and when they retire or they reach a certain amount of money or whatever it is, then they're gonna have fun and they're gonna enjoy their life. Then they're gonna really live their life, right? I did a video a while back on waiting for your life to begin. Stop waiting for your life to begin, essentially. I think that's what it was called, but you should check that video out. But anyway, I just wanna give you this one really, really important concept. I just wanna drill this in your head, right? Why I'm saying this, because a lot of people disagree with the work-life balancing and they say, oh, you gotta have this. And what I'm saying is this, I'm just saying this. Your life is your life, okay? You know, I've had to re-experience this a little bit. I have to remind myself all the time, because sometimes I get into that mode, I'm like, oh fuck, I gotta get this stuff done, gotta get this work done. And I don't even have to get it done, right? I mean, I don't have to work, right? I don't know if you've seen my video on what it was like to make $1 million. I'm not gonna rehash all this stuff, but you could check that out. But I don't have to go to, and no one is compelling me. I can live without, I've got passive income that comes in, right? You know, so, but I still get in that mindset and I'm thinking, oh, I got to get this stuff done. I got to get this work done. And I'm not enjoying that. But this week I was just, you know, going over this in my head and I said, man, you know what, John? You can like be editing your book right now. And you could be enjoying this process. This could be fun. This could be your life, because this is your life, because this is the choice that you've made. You've chosen to live this life this way. You've chosen to spend this time. You're making this choice. So if you're gonna make the fucking choice, you better be pretty fucking happy about it. You know what I'm saying? That's the whole thing. And so just remember that. When you wake up in the morning, when you go to your job, when you get in your car, when you commute, when you go to the gym, when you do your fucking laundry, okay? You made that choice. So be happy about that. That's great. That's your life. It's happiness. It's not sadness. It's not work. It's not shit you have to do. It's shit you get to do because you chose it. Now, you might like money and you might like eating, and that might be why you work, but you know what? It's your life, right? Whether you like it or not, whether it's the most ideal conditions that you would have for yourself, it is your life. So you got to start to figure out how to actually live your life, not just in the 6 hours after work, that little window that you have every day, not just on the weekends, not just on your 2 week vacation per year, not that. It's gotta be every single day. It's gotta be every single moment because, you know, as far as I know, you only get one shot at this. So just wanted to hit that home. As I was going through that chapter, I realized that this is a really, really important message. And so many people don't realize this. And I have to remind myself this all the time. I got to remind myself, man, I get to do this. I get to do this. And if I don't want to do this, I don't have to do this, right? It's always a choice. There's always a choice in life. But the one choice that you can consistently make that's always the best choice is whatever you are doing, put yourself all into it. Make that your life. Don't wait. Don't wait for the clock. Never wait for the clock to tick down and waste a second of your life. Wasting 1 second regretting where you are right now and what you're doing right now is a waste of oxygen. It's a waste of life. And it's not going to serve you. That's all I got. All right. Hopefully that was deep enough for you. If you like this video, if you haven't subscribed already, I say this all the time, but hey, you know, some of you search on Simple Programmer all the time on YouTube, but you don't subscribe. Click the subscribe button, click that bell if you want to get notified. I know some of you have been complaining that some of the videos haven't been showing up in your subscription list. Click that bell and they definitely will. You can always ignore the ones that you don't want to watch. I will talk to you next time. Take care.